Hello everyone, this is Sanjay Parashar. Welcome back to our channel. And today we are going to talk about the latest version of SOA 12.2.1.4, which was released in September 2019. And this video is requested by one of our subscribers named Mr. Datta. So he is facing issues while installing 12.2.1.4, and that got me thinking that okay, let me try and replicate this issue and see if we can fix that from our end. So before we do that, let me tell you what is new in 12.2.1.4. So as I said, it is released in September 2019, and it is not a major release from 12.2.1.3. So if you already have it, 12.2.1.3, then I would not recommend you guys to upgrade it to 1.4. And if you guys need anything in detail, that what are the security certificate that has been updated, what are the bugs that has been fixed, I'll recommend you guys to go through this doc ID 2067900.1 from support.oracle.com. So to install it, we first need to download, as you can see in this screenshot right here, that we need to download these quick installers. And once we download it, exactly the way we do for 12.2.1.3, we'll do it here. We'll set the environment variables if you have not set already. That is Java home and path. And then we will simply extract the jar, the first jar file. So guys, once your jar is extracted, you will come to this welcome home screen of Oracle Quick Start Installation Wizard window. You click on next. You can skip the auto updates. We'll keep it like this. Click on next. And this is where we will provide the Oracle home as per whatever directory that you wish to give. You do it. Click on next. And this is where Mr. Datta was experiencing this issue. However, for me, there is no issue as such as of now. So let's proceed further. Once we click on next, it will do this process bar. We'll click on next again, and there will be a summary of all the related files that are going to be installed with this package. We'll click on install, and it might take some time for the entire thing to get installed, so I have paused and resumed the video so that I want it to be as short as possible. Once it is completed, click on next, and we can finish it from here. So guys, as it is exactly the same as we have done previously with 1.3 version, so I'm not going to dig deeper, and we can start the server from start weblogic command. And once your server is up and running, you will see this message: SOA platform is running and accepting requests. Here you can log into your console with the username and password that you set when you configured the domain. And the moment you provide username and password, you will be able to log in, and you can check that the server is up and running. So this is it guys, this concludes our today's video, and we did not run into any issue. So Mr. Datta, you can get some perspective by looking at this video if there is something that you're doing incorrectly while installing it. If not, feel free to drop me an email. We can also have a session together, and I'll make sure that your issue will be fixed. So everyone, please take good care of yourselves and have a nice day ahead.